In this video, I'm going to show you how to keep your video projects organized so you don't spend time hunting down missing videos or have to confront the dreaded file missing notification. Hi, I'm Andy from TechSmith, where we help you show what you know. Is your workstation immaculate, or does it have a few things out of place? How much easier is it for a big mess to overwhelm us when we start a project already disorganized? The same is true when you're making a video. One of the biggest mistakes I see when people start making videos is that they don't keep everything organized. When you start editing, those big video files need to be placed in the right folders so that one, you always know where they are, and two, you don't accidentally duplicate files without realizing it, doubling the size of your projects on your hard drive. Plus, when you're working on a team, no one has to ask where you saved something because there's a standard in place. In fact, once you're editing, moving files into different folders causes all kinds of problems. If you've ever tried, you know what happens. Moving files before you're done using them in your edit means your software loses track of the file location and you get that terrifying file missing notification. Let's avoid that by starting with an organized folder structure. For my video projects, I use the same 6 folders and a handful of subfolders. I name the main project folder based on the project's title, then every project will have the same 6 folders underneath: projects, videos, audio, images, documents, and finals. And because my computer defaults to alphabetizing these, they'll arrange themselves in a way I don't like, so I choose to number them like this: 00 projects, 01 video, 02 audio, 03 images, 04 documents, 05 finals. Obviously, you don't have to do that. You can make this your own. Maybe you don't like having the zeros in front, but if you choose to have more than 10 folders, you'll be glad you did. Either way, this is just an example. Feel free to set up your folders however works best for you. Some people like to use dates in their main project. If you do that, I recommend starting with the 2-digit year, then month, then day to keep folders chronological. Be sure to be consistent and you'll be able to find assets in any folder down the road. And before I tell you more about the individual folders themselves, let me also mention the importance of naming your video files. Most cameras and recording software gives a default untitled or other similarly numbered name. You'll very quickly become buried in untitled videos and projects if you don't intentionally name it with a familiar, content-related title. All right, let's jump back into those folders now. The projects folder. Any and all project files go in here. This contains my Camtasia project, any After Effects, Snagit, or Photoshop files I might create for the video. Sometimes I make multiple versions of the same project, so I'll name them appropriately, such as Draft 1, or even just add a date to the title for a quick reference. The video folder. Okay, a lot of these are obvious, but any and all videos go into this folder. That includes camera footage, screen recordings, if I recorded a webinar or Zoom meeting. Any and all video footage is found here. The audio folder. Now, I always have 2 subfolders in my audio folder: narration and music. You don't have to do it this way, but if I bring in narration, I keep those files in a folder separate from the royalty-free music I've selected for my soundtrack. See what I did there? Sneakily talked about royalty-free music. We have a video on adding music to a project linked here. And you want to make sure you don't just add your favorite song from Spotify. It doesn't work like that. The images folder. I used to call it pictures, then I changed it to graphics. Again, with time, these things may evolve. I now just refer to it as images. Maybe you're animating a slideshow, so the whole thing is made up of JPEGs. This is where they should live. Also, maybe you created animated graphics in After Effects. Ooh, look at you. The rendered graphics should live here. But the project you created them in? That's right, it's back in 00 projects. The documents folder. This is where the scripts live. For an interview, this may be where the transcripts live. I also include any image releases or legal documents I need to keep with the rest of my project. Honestly, this folder sees the least amount of use for me personally, but it's always there just in case I need it. The finals folder, my favorite folder, because this means you've finished your edit and you're ready to export. I tend to have subfolders here as well: drafts and approved. I put exports in the drafts folder until the video is complete and all stakeholders have signed off on it. You can delete the drafts folder after the video is approved, or you can keep them all, but watch your hard drive space if you do that. Video files can be huge. We also export captions with our videos, typically in the .srt file format. Even though they're technically documents, because they need to stay with the video, I put those with the approved final video in its folder. And that's it. A perfectly contained project folder with organized subfolders. Now, you will never accidentally delete a media file because it was in a random spot in your downloads folder, or have to spend time hunting down a lost file to reconnect it. You can easily share your entire project with team members, and when someone needs to find your files, they'll know right where to look. Plus, your machine won't slow down, and crash by pulling files from different internal and external drives from all over your computer. I hope this helped. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like. And if you want to know when we make more great content, be sure to subscribe to the channel and click the bell to be notified as we release more videos. Thanks for watching.